Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome back. I brought you out to the Arizona desert again. It's a little bit cold and windy today, but that's okay because we are here for the view. Now, we found a location where apparently it's okay to break glass, and that's a good thing because I have a potentially deconstructive experiment that I've been wanting to try with this glass vacuum chamber. Now, I got the idea of using a glass cookie jar for my cousin Ty Moser, but there was a concern that they could implode violently. So the purpose of this experiment is to push the boundaries and get them to go off, so we can see that when they do implode, how violent and how far-reaching is that shrapnel gonna be. So let me show you the setup we've got rigged out here today. The idea is to assemble the vacuum chamber and pull 25 inches of mercury to create the strongest vacuum that we can get with this system. Then I'm gonna shut off the valve to keep the vacuum pressure, turn off the pump, and use a hammer to gently tap the side so we can test just how much force it'll take to get the sidewalls to crack and make the whole system implode. Now, normally, if you were to put something into a container and make it explode, it'll shoot shards in every different direction. Now, this is a little bit different because we're sucking all the air out of the jar and it's creating a vacuum pressure, sucking everything inside. If the structural integrity of the jar fails, everything should pull in and smash in the middle. I've also got a face shield, extra layers of clothing, and some really thick gloves because even if it does smash inward, I do expect shards of glass will spray in every different direction. So let's suck out the air, grab a hammer, and see how everything turns out. What does a GoPro do in a vacuum chamber? We're gonna find that out too. All right, guys, it's action time, and truthfully, I'm a little bit nervous because I'm not sure what to expect, so we're just gonna have to jump in to find out.
Let's get that gauge rising.
Now, you see the gauge is rising right now. We're pulling about, we're coming up on 20 inches of mercury. 25 inches of mercury is the highest we can go with this vacuum pump. That's the strongest vacuum we can get. This one's designed to suck out air conditioning units, so it's actually a very strong vacuum. Once it hits 25 inches of mercury, I'm gonna turn off the valve so it maintains vacuum pressure in the jar. Then I'm gonna turn off the vacuum pump so it stops making noise and we can get the full effect of the implosion. All right, it looks like it's time. I'm not really sure how close I should be to this thing, so I'm just gonna kind of attack it from a distance and start off with some gentle taps and then see exactly what it'll take to crack it and make it go off. There's a gentle tap. Let's try that again. Okay. It's actually holding up pretty well. I'm gonna tap it a little bit harder. A little bit harder. A little bit harder. I think I actually chipped the glass on that one. It's still holding up. I'm gonna hit it even harder. Whoa! Winding up. There it goes. And there's like a mist of glass dust that shoots out of the top and just blows with the wind. Even if I wasn't wearing any protective clothing, I think I still would have been okay because any glass that would have come at me would be so low energy, it would just bounce off with not much difficulty. But it's always a good idea to be wearing safety equipment though. Check this out, guys. Check this out. My proto putty looks like it stayed intact. You could just pop that off and reuse it on another jar. So looking at the damage down here, guys, you can see the bottom of the jar is completely annihilated. There's chunks of it over here, chunks of it over there, and about a billion pieces of it over here. But I am pretty encouraged because most of it stayed in one spot. There weren't any jagged pieces that shot out, and that's what I was worried about. I might have to make a new one of these lids now because I ruined the finish. That's too bad. I think it still took just as much effort to crack the sidewall as it would if it was at standard atmospheric pressure. If you went to the hardware store and got one of those 1 foot concrete pavers and tried to smash that with a hammer, I think it would take about the same amount of force to crack that in half as it would to break this jar. That's just based on feeling, that's not scientific, that's just my opinion. That was the large jar. How will the small jar do? Will it be able to withstand more force because it's smaller? Let's go find out. I can't tell if this thing is actually working right now. The LCD screen is completely shot, but the red light's flashing, so I'm gonna stick it in and see if we can get another shot with the smaller vacuum chamber. All right, I got the vacuum pump off. Let's smash it. All right, I'm gonna give this one a pretty good whack here. Woo! Very nice, very nice. So every time we have a rapid decompression, it seems like my GoPro just shuts off. The LCD screen has imploded. It's gone completely dark and I can't see anything. I'm just hoping that we recovered some of that footage because that would be cool to see. If you look down here though, you can see the proto putty gasket just popped right off and it's still in really good condition. We could just pop that onto another jar and reuse it again. The only difference is look really closely here and you can see a very fine mist of glass dust. So when this thing imploded, it made a cloud of dust that pops out the top and covers everything. I can't tell if the ground was shaking or if it was just a pressure wave, but the camera jumped there. It almost looked like the dirt does suck up from the bottom. That's really crazy. It just kind of rises and falls in the same spot. Now, since we got one more small jar left, let's switch things up a little bit. So rather than smashing it with a hammer, let's try lifting it up and dropping it on a rock instead. All right, we're at 25. How high do I have to drop it before this thing will break? Let's just start off here at about 6 inches. That was enough to do it. Maybe I should have started off at 6 inches. That was more like a foot. And it just crumbles. When it hits the rock, it just completely disappears. You gotta see that again. There's the drop, and boom. That's amazing. Yep, no explosion. It just completely disintegrates, and the lid keeps falling at the same rate. So that's very cool. So why would you even use a cookie jar for a vacuum chamber? Well, for me, it's just to be able to see inside and look at the reactions going on. You could spend hundreds of dollars on big professional glass bell jars that are designed for that purpose, but after testing here today, I personally am pretty comfortable moving forward with glass cookie jars from now on. As long as you're not dinging them, denting them, throwing rocks at them, or hitting with hammers, they should hold up relatively well. But that doesn't mean you shouldn't wear safety equipment. It's good to be prepared. So there you have it, guys. Looks like I'm not going home with any extra holes in my body today, so I think we can call that a successful test. It's really cool to see just what happens when a glass vacuum chamber implodes. And don't worry about this mess, we'll be cleaning up before we leave. Hey, thanks for joining me for this experiment. I'll be looking for you in the next one. Talk to you then. Hey guys, thanks for watching, and remember, I'm giving away prizes now on every new video. All you have to do to qualify is subscribe to my channel, ring the bell, and select to be notified when my next videos get released. The secret link to my giveaways will be pinned in the comments for the first 12 hours. If you like what I'm doing, show your support right now by giving this video a big thumbs up and share with a friend. I love you back, and I'll see you next time.